Congress passes the most sweeping civil rights bill ever to be written into the law, and thus reaffirms the conception of equality for all men that began with Lincoln and the Civil War 100 years ago. The Negro won his freedom then. He wins his dignity now.
Over the last 50 years, the United States has passed a variety of laws, most significantly the Civil Rights Act of 1964, to prevent workplace discrimination, to protect workers. Workers are protected on the basis of race, sex, age, disability, and under certain circumstances, sexual orientation or gender identity.
Despite having laws on the books that say that discrimination is illegal, it's quite common. We decided to write our book, Rights on Trial, because we wanted to understand how well the system of litigation, how the legal system more generally, is remedying inequality in the workplace. We rely on law to protect us from discrimination, but law is not self-enforcing. So we wanted to go in and find the facts and figures, hear the stories to understand how well law is really protecting people and enabling them to create the change they want to create and have the protections that they need to bring their full selves to work.
14,000 employment civil rights lawsuits are filed in federal court every year. 19% of those cases are dismissed very early on. Half of the cases settle early for a small sum. 18% of cases are dismissed on motion for summary judgment, which means that a judge decides that there is not an issue for trial. 8% of cases filed in federal court settle after motion for summary judgment. 6% of cases filed go to trial. Plaintiffs win in these cases about 30% of the time, meaning 2% of cases filed wind up with a plaintiff winning at trial.
We are scholars of law and inequality, and in particular we're interested in how law intervenes to try and reduce inequality. The subtitle of the book is How Workplace Discrimination Law Perpetuates Inequality. And the sad thing is that even though Americans revere rights, and employers say they are very strongly in favor of discrimination law, we tend to reject the people who make rights claims. And therefore, for a variety of reasons, the processes by which rights are litigated in our society tends to reinforce the very patterns of inequality that the law was intended to eliminate or remedy.
An important part of our book is that it gives readers the opportunity to hear the stories of the people who participate in litigation. And because we have the audio recordings online of the plaintiff's attorneys, the human resource managers and defense counsel who were involved in litigation, you see each of their perspectives, interpretations, experiences of what was happening in the legal case. And that gives you an insight into what it's like to go through litigation.